కరెక్ట్ లెన్స్.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్, మై సెల్ఫ్ డాక్టర్ సేతు మంజుష ఫ్రమ్ ద డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఓరల్ మెడిసిన్ అండ్ రేడియాలజీ. టుడే ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ డెమో ఆన్ బైట్ వింగ్ రేడియోగ్రాఫ్. ద బైట్ వింగ్ రేడియోగ్రాఫ్స్ దీస్ ఆర్ యూస్డ్ టు అసెస్ ద అక్లూషల్ సర్ఫేసెస్ అండ్ ద అల్వియర్ క్రస్ట్ ఆఫ్ మాక్సిలరీ అండ్ మాండిబులర్ టీత్. దీస్ కవర్స్ ద క్రౌన్ పోర్షన్స్ ఆఫ్ బోత్ ద ఆర్చెస్. దీస్ కెన్ బి టేకెన్ ఫర్ ప్రీమోలర్స్ అండ్ మోలర్స్. సో I will explain the instrument that we are using for this biting radiograph. This is a XCP instrument for biting, where we will be having an external guiding ring and a bite plate and size 2 film. So let's take a demo on the patient. Once the patient sit on the dental chair, greet the patient, and so on which side you are going to take the biting radiograph, please make sure to make the arrangement of the tube on that side. Now I am going to take on the left side. So I'll ask the patient to open the oral cavity and ask the patient to bite on the bite plate. So I will, this external guiding ring will guide my X-ray tube. So once after arranging, I will place my X-ray tube related to the external ring and I will choose the milliseconds on my control panel, and once it started, then I will shoot the film. Thank you. Good morning. Myself, Dr. Setu Manjusha from the Department of Oral Medicine and Radiology. Today, I am going to give demo on occlusal radiograph. This is the occlusal film. The size of this film is 3 times greater than size 2 film. It is having a colored surface and a white surface. This white surface or the raised embossed dot should be towards your tube head. So in this film, we will cover the entire maxillary or mandibular arch depending upon the patient condition or the situation. So we will, for the maxillary radiograph, occlusal radiograph, it is of 3 types: maxillary anterior, maxillary cross sectional and maxillary lateral. For the mandible also the same thing: mandibular anterior, mandibular cross sectional and the mandibular lateral radiograph. So let's have a demo on the patient. I will show all the types of the occlusal radiograph on the patient. So let's have a look. So in the first, I am taking for the maxillary anterior radiograph, which covers from the canine to canine. So ask the patient to open his or her mouth and place your occlusal film so that the long axis of the film should be perpendicular to the sagittal plane. So, and your posterior borders of the film should touch the ramus. Once you place the patient, ask the patient to close the lips and arrange your angulation on the tube head. For the maxillary anterior radiograph, the angulation should be plus 45 degrees. So once I arrange, the central ray should pass through the tip of the nose. So this is for the maxillary anterior radiograph. Let's have a look for the maxillary cross-sectional or topographic radiograph. In this, we will place the occlusal film a bit posterior so that it covers the entire arch, and we will ask the patient to bite on the film. And here we will change the angulation to plus 65 degrees. So once I change the angulation, my central ray should pass through the bridge of the nose, that is from the below the nasion, so that it covers the entire maxillary arch from molar to molar. And then coming to the lateral maxillary radiograph, here we will place the radiograph on the side of our interest, either right or left depending upon the patient need. So I am showing now for the maxillary left lateral radiograph. Here the long axis of the film should be parallel to the sagittal plane, and ask the patient to open the mouth and place the film on that particular side. Ask the patient to bite on the film. Change the angulation to plus 60 degrees, place the tube on that side and the central ray should be 2 centimeters below the lateral canthus of the eye. So this is your maxillary lateral radiograph. Let's have a look on the mandibular occlusal radiographs. For the mandibular anterior radiograph, as I said, the white surface should be towards the tube side. So for the mandibular anterior radiograph, the patient's occlusal plane should be 45 degrees to the floor or the horizontal plane. So the patient head should be raised so that it should be 45 degrees to the occlusal plane. Place the patient's film inside the patient's oral cavity. Ask the patient to bite and then adjust your angulation to minus 10 degrees and then expose the film through the tip of the chin. Okay, so here by minus 10 degrees and the 45 degrees overall makes an angulation of minus 55 degrees. So let's have a demo on mandibular topographic or mandibular cross-sectional radiograph. Here the patient position should be semi-reclined. So patient should be semi-reclined position and the film should be pushed a bit backward so that it should touch the ramus of the mandible. And your exposure should be towards the, should be 3 centimeters below the tip of the chin. So this is the mandibular cross-sectional radiograph. So let's have a demo on the lateral mandibular radiograph. So I am placing the lateral mandibular radiograph on the left side. Ask the patient to bite on the radiograph and patient head should be in the semi-reclined position and your exposure should be 3 centimeters below the chin and 3 centimeters towards the side of the interest. By adjusting that X-ray tube, expose the film. These are the various types of the occlusal radiographs we are taking depending upon the case situation. Thank you.